All right, everybody, here's another installment of eBay Wednesdays. So I was hopping around a little bit a few weeks back, and I've been watching Tom Lipton, oxtool, and A-Bomb 79. Two great machinists that can learn worlds of information from both of them. And I had been watching them use these Noga dial indicator stands, these magnetic dial indicator stands. And I had learned a long time ago from Keith Fenner up at Termite Machine Works. He had a steret dial, magnetic base dial indicator, and anytime you say steret, you know, my ears kind of perk up. And I found one of those at a pretty good price on eBay and picked it up some time ago, and I've used it with great success. And so it was interesting to see Tom and Adam show the Noga and how they like to use it. And you know, these guys are, they're daily drivers, they use these things all the time, so it was interesting to see their take on it and their experience with it. So it kind of got me looking on eBay to see if I could find a Noga, because if you want this particular one brand new, everyday price is about $144 or so. Sometimes you can find it on sale for $99 at Inco or MSC or something like that. So I've been keeping my eye out, and I came across an auction that had these three items in it, and it's a Noga magnetic base indicator. This, I believe, is the medium size, and it has this Fowler dial indicator, and then it had this what could possibly be an import set of radius gauges. I'd kind of been looking for a set for a while, and it's basically allows you to you know, validate or sum up an internal or an external radius. And with some of the work that I do, I kind of want to keep them all in line. So having a set of gauges or radius gauges was something I'd kind of been looking for. So this auction caught my eye because it had a little bit of everything. Now, I don't see a name on this at all, so I assume it came from across the pond. Now, the Fowler indicator and the person that mentioned this stated that the needle was bent on it. And in fact, the needle is bent. I'm not sure what happened there, but the movement is very smooth, no issue there. The bezel still moves, and pretty much the sub dial lands on zero. And for what I can tell, it seems fine. It does have a metal base on the back, which is good. And you know, it's not in bad shape. Now, it's missing the tip, but that's something that could be easily replaced. So I was like, okay, well, this looks like an interesting deal. So I was able to get all three of these for $74.99. And the Noga is in really good shape. It's definitely been used, but it's not abused. And for setting, you know, setting up a job or whatnot, I was like, well, wouldn't it be kind of awkward to use one of these? I mean, this, just for comparison's sake, here's the go-to steret 657 magnetic button on the bottom, lets it be magnetic on the sides, the bottom, and even this groove if you're trying to tram your mill or something like that. Really nice finish, typical steret quality. You know, there's nothing wrong with that at all. And so watching these guys use these, it was really interesting. So, you know, you can put this in here, and you've got a little bit of fine adjustment right here where you can kind of tilt it a little bit. They also make a fine adjustment on the bottom. But the interesting thing was, and I don't have a good hunk of metal to attach to, but they would take it and turn the magnet on, and then one-handed or two-handed, they could basically loosen this up, put it on what they want to put it on, and tighten it down, and this thing doesn't move. And so, you know, seeing these, I'm like, oh, that's probably the best. But seeing these guys use these Nogas, and the good quality that this is, it's ridiculous, the finish on this, just for it to be a test indicator stand, you know, it's like a piece of jewelry. The finish is so good. So I was pretty happy to be able to snag one of these, and so I'm looking forward to putting it to good use. So the Fowler, was it worth it or not? I don't know. I think the stand was definitely worth it. It's in good enough shape to justify the price, and then having the radius gauges and whatnot, I think that was a good find. So if you're looking for a good dial test indicator stand, the Noga is great. The steret is also great, and you see the size difference there, but I think for the ease of use, The Noga probably wins hands down. So if it's something you're looking for, be sure to keep your eye out on eBay and see if you can score one. They also make some that's called a CIN arm, C-I-N-E-A-R-M, and that's for like holding cameras or holding photography lights or stuff like that. They make those. It's the same premise. It just doesn't come with a magnetic base, and it usually has a quarter inch thread, quarter 20 thread on the end. But this comes in a smaller size and a gargantuan size as well. So Noga, N-O-G-A, be sure to keep your eye out. And if this is something you might be looking for, whether it's to use for test indicators or cameras or lights or what have you, you might be able to find you a good deal. I've seen some go for, and I can kick myself, but I've seen some go for as low as $40, $45, something like that. So be sure to keep your eye out for those good deals, because they're still out there. Appreciate all the new subscribers. Thanks for stopping by and checking us out. Looking forward to getting back into the CNC track. Still working on the KR33 system, and so stay tuned for that. Had a lot of interest in that, more than I thought I would get, so I'm really looking forward to moving along with that. So be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and we will talk to you next time.